Mwah! Perfect! No, 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 no! Oh, hi! Yeah, I'm making a little art as a way of getting ready for today's exciting new episode.
You've been listening to WOOF, the weather forecast today. 20% chance of thunderstorms. Now back to our music.
Oh, 20%, huh? Oh, I hope it doesn't rain. The challenge I planned for... That sounded like thunder. Excuse me a moment. Oh, hi! I was just looking under here for, you know, I had, Okay, look. I don't have brontophobia, if that's what you're thinking. Brontophobia is a fear of thunder, and that's just silly. I mean, who in their right mind would really be afraid of... Okay, I have a little brontophobia. It's a dog thing. But it sounds like the thunder has stopped, which is good, because, you know, I can't very well host a show from underneath here now, can I? Oh, I don't know, maybe I can.
Life was missing its mystique, my squeaky toys had lost their squeak.
And then, out of the blue, I saw the phone, and bam! My destiny was calling me!
Pitched my vision for a show, they loved it, thought I was a pro! They got my contract back to find, to their alarm, a dog had signed! Oh, I like that name. I didn't wait to renovate, found six contestants, all were great! And now I'm on the road to fame, I've got a game show and its name is... It's very catchy. It rolls off the tongue. Wait, stop!
Somebody want to tell me why we got cats singing?
Funding for Fetch with Ruff Ruffman has been provided by the National Science Foundation, where discoveries begin. The Arthur Vining Davis Foundation, dedicated to strengthening America's future through education. And by Arby's. And by Green Dog.
And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
And here come the contestants now. Art is his favorite subject at school. Bring it on, Noah. She plays the drums, you've got to beat Julia! When people hold out their S's, it annoys her, it's... Anna! Her favorite book is Treasure Island! Shiver me timbers, it's Taylor! Is not a fan of the asparagus, Brian! He likes gospel music, Khalil! Let's get an update on the scores! In sixth place with 670 points is Taylor. In fifth with 736 is Julia. In fourth place, 755 points, we have Noah. Brian in third with 760. Khalil in second place with 785. And with 811 points, Anna in first place.
Hey, what's going on, Ruff?
Hello and welcome to Fetch with Ruff Ruffman. Brought to you 3,000 miles beneath the Earth's surface.
Why are you hiding from us?
I'm not hiding. I'm under the Fetch 3,000, of course.
What are you doing under the Fetch 3,000?
All right. I'll fess up. I was hiding. I have a little bit of brontophobia.
Brontophobia? What's a bronto?
It's actually the fear of thunder.
It's not thundering outside.
It stopped raining and thundering?
It never was thundering.
It never was. I need to check the weather report. I mean, boot up the Fetch 3,000.
Good evening. Thanks for tuning in to CBS 4 News.
Mish Michaels. I love her. She's a close personal friend of the Ruffster, you know that. That gives me a great idea for challenge number one. I'm going to be sending one of you to Channel 4 to do their own weather report with Mish Michaels. And that person is going to be Taylor. Taylor, I hope you have your raincoat, your rain hat, your sunglasses, and all the props a good meteorologist will need. Your challenge is in the mailbox. Go, Fetch!
Go, Taylor.
Taylor, say hi to Mish for me.
Okay.
All right, challenge number two. Three of you will be braving the elements to make art. So if it's raining cats and dogs out there, you better hope it's more dog and not so much cat. Brian, Khalil, Noah, the details for your challenge are in the mailbox as well as your paintbrushes and your pizza box. Go!
Pizza box.
You'll understand when you get there.
See you later, guys.
See you on.
It's a cool pizza box.
Well, I guess it's just us. We're gonna have a great old time because as determined by the Fetch 3000, Anna and Julia have stayed behind in the studio this week.
But it's not going to be a boring afternoon because you'll be eligible to win points during the halftime quiz show. Don't worry. You have the Fetch Fairness Guarantee. By the time the amazing and incredible grand prize is awarded, all the contestants will have competed for the same number of points in the challenge and same number of points in the halftime quiz shows.
Well, that's fair.
So, for the four kids out on the challenges, up to 100 points are at stake in the Triumph Tally. So let's catch up with Taylor in Stormy Challenge number one.
Hi, you miss?
I am.
Hi, I'm Taylor.
Are you Taylor?
Yeah, hi.
Tonight, you are doing my job. I get the night off, and you are going to do the weather tonight.
So wow, this is going to be awesome.
So what got you interested in being a meteorologist? Like, did you start when you were little?
Well, actually, when I was younger than you, a tornado went through my neighborhood, knocked down all these trees, turned over cars.
Oh, wow.
But I thought, wow, ever since then, I've been always looking up at the sky, seeing what's going to happen.
What do you got? Ruff has us to do. He gave us a pizza.
Why would he give us a pizza?
So that you could also bring me back some pizza when you're done.
We have to find this kid named Cyrus.
Yeah.
What was Zesto's pizza?
Oh, cool.
We're looking for someone named Cyrus.
Okay, I'm Cyrus. How's it going?
Hey, I'm Brian.
Nice to meet you, fellas. All right, I work for the mayor's mural crew.
That's kind of cool. The mayor has his own crew.
We're actually glad that you're here because we need some help. We have to paint this entire wall in a day.
That's right. Challenge number one, paint that wall. All
right, I'm going to introduce you to our director, Heidi.
Hey, Ruff told me you were coming today.
Ah, it's Heidi.
What's up?
What was that pizza for?
Yeah.
Because this is a pizza restaurant.
That's right.
They've asked us to paint this on the side of the restaurant. Now, sometimes when we're working, the mayor of Boston pulls up.
Ooh. I think we might be seeing some mayor today.
This is what we're going to be painting. This is a small picture that we have to put on a big wall.
Oh, it's going to take a lot of paint.
What we did is we took this old photograph of Jamaica Pond and we made a grid. We divided up the wall.
Wow, they're really going fast.
The wall is 13 feet high and 26 feet long. Each one of these squares is 2 feet by 2 feet. These are the colors we're going to be using.
What if we can't paint to save our life?
I'll show you what to do. That's my job.
Don't you worry about it. Heidi's going to take care of you, Brian.
I'm a scientist, and I studied meteorology for 4 years in college. And meteorology is all about mathematics and using computers to understand how the weather is going to play out over time. Weather, it covers the entire globe. It never takes a break. And what drives the weather is the sun. The sun heats the globe, and because our Earth is round, parts of our Earth get more heat than other parts of the Earth, and that is the driver of all of our atmospheric patterns and all the storms.
What exactly is the atmosphere?
The atmosphere is where weather happens, the lowest layer of the atmosphere that covers the entire globe, and it moves like the ocean in big waves, and certain waves make storms, certain waves make good weather. Taylor, let me show you how I collect data to create a forecast.
Okay.
First stop, Doppler radar.
Okay.
This radar shows where precipitation is falling.
Like rain?
Like rain, and in the wintertime?
Snow and sleet.
Exactly. Everywhere you see these little green shaded areas indicates...
thunderstorms?
You got it. And the brighter the color...
The more rain?
The heavier the rain. See all those flashing symbols?
Yes. Oh, that's lightning?
That's lightning. We also look at satellite imagery to collect information
about the weather. I do satellite interviews.
Let's go to a place where there's lots of clouds, though. We travel down to the Gulf of Mexico.
Oh, wow.
There's a lot of cloud.
What do you think that might be?
Is it like a hurricane?
It is a hurricane.
Oh, wow.
And it's moving over the warm waters of the Gulf of Mexico. And those warm waters help to strengthen a hurricane.
So once they get onto land, they start to get weak.
Exactly. But right around that clear center is where the strongest winds of Hurricane Emily are blowing. So we have all these ways to look at the atmosphere, but what if I want to look at the atmosphere in the days to come? The atmosphere, it's like a fluid. And the way that we understand the fluid is by using physics and mathematics. Physical laws of motion help us understand how the weather might play out over the days to come. This is a map of the United States, and it shows that atmosphere in motion. So where we live, north of the equator, weather's always traveling from west to east.
Uh-huh.
So why is this down here going this way?
Great question, Taylor.
Closer to the equator, weather travels from east to west.
It's really, really hot today, so have a hat. Okay,
How come you paint it in black and yellow first?
It's really hard to find where you're supposed to put your color. So you make a sketch in black and white first, and then we put it on the wall in yellow. I'm gonna assign you this corner over here.
Can we have a partner too? Because
Brian is not very confident in his painting skills.
No, why don't you try to figure it out first? But I think you'll be fine.
I'll be in deep trouble within 5 minutes.
No. Have confidence.
We had a tech lab project this year. I was drawing an alligator on it. My teacher goes, "Oh, Brian, that's a very pretty turtle."
You shouldn't get down on yourself, Brian. Turtles and alligators, very similar. It's really all a turtle is an alligator with a shell, I think. I don't know. I'm gonna have to look that up.
Put your brush in and then wipe it off in the side, and then you can draw with it. You're on square number one, this one right here.
But I really just moved my brush around and I have no clue.
I think he's doing pretty well so far.
This is tedious work, bro. Lucky you're in an air-conditioned studio.
That didn't seem that bad from in here. I'm out of smoothie.
Hey, Fetch 3000, you want to whip me up another frosty one?
I'm meteorologist Mish Michaels. It is dawn on the summit of Mount Washington.
To tell a good weather story, you need to know your audience. I spoke with our buddy Ruff, who apparently has some weather phobias.
I know. I got a couple.
Ruff, it's going to be okay. Don't worry. So you are going to head out on the streets, and you are going to ask people what they know about storms. So we can really understand our audience, so we can give them a good forecast.
Okay.
So first challenge for Taylor is to get out there, interview the general public, see what they know about weather.
Here comes someone. Maybe I can get him. She's not stopping.
Let's try somebody else.
Excuse me. You think you can answer a few questions for me?
Sure.
Okay. Do you know how storms form? How they form?
I'm not entirely sure, actually.
Oh, okay.
It's a collision between a higher pressure system and a lower pressure system, which causes the disturbance.
Was that thunder?
We are getting hammered with heavy rain.
Storms form from areas of low pressure. There's low pressure at the ground, and all the atmosphere is being pushed up with really strong winds that go up, take all the moisture, form clouds, and those clouds form rain, snow, blizzards.
Do you know how hurricanes are named?
Hey, don't they start like at the beginning of the season, they start with A, and they give it a name, and then they go B, C, D, E, and it goes guy, girl, something like
That's exactly right.
Those names are picked from various ethnic backgrounds that are impacted in the Atlantic Ocean.
What is the safest thing to do if you're caught in a storm?
Run away, I guess.
And the basement.
Best place to be is inside in your home.
Under the Fetch 3000.
Do you think pets can predict weather?
Yes.
A lot of people think that's an old wives' tale. I'm telling you, it's true.
Probably birds, maybe.
Excuse me.
Oh, you're not going to get any information from a bird.
Mr. Bird, sir, excuse me. Do you think you can predict the weather?
You need to ask a dog.
Oh, yes, these guys know.
Folks, please. Those
are
always
Brooklyn, they're happy to see
embarrassing
you.
Me. That's what you're doing.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Good, oh, great.
Definitely want to fill in the cracks.
Doesn't it look like I know what I'm doing?
I think now is a good time for us to step back from the wall.
What do you think?
It looks good.
Good.
Looks even better.
It does look good.
Distance. Right.
Boy, that's filling in really fast.
Starting to come together now. You see how the path is appearing?
Oh, there's the path. Yep.
And those are the bushes.
Bushes right
and then
there.
Up above the bushes is where the pond is.
Oh, yeah, the pond from the picture.
Can I speak to George, please? So we're working on a mural. You want to go take a look?
Sure.
What do you think?
Wow, looks really good.
I think George digs
it. I like it a lot, actually.
We're gonna let it dry, then we're gonna paint over it with the real colors.
It's got a lot of work ahead of you, but it looks good.
Keep up the good work, guys.
So about how many years will this last?
This will last 8 or 9 years.
Every time you drive by the pizza shop and say, hey, I helped out with this mural.
It's halftime here at Studio G, and I am with Anna and Julia. Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Well, before we go any further, I'd just like to say that I have solved the mystery of my thunderless thunder. The Fetch 3000 security cams have picked up the answer. Twiddles, the neighborhood cat, was rolling this metal drum outside of my doghouse, and that triggered my brontophobia. I'd just like to say this to the cat community. Not nice. Somebody needs to speak to somebody because I expect some kind of an apology. Now it's time for the halftime quiz show.
I'm pumped.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Question number one. Let's say we just had a hurricane named Jill. What would be a potential name for the next hurricane?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. It's an H, it's a boy, H. Horace.
No, that is incorrect. What are two examples of precipitation?
Snow and rain.
Correct. True or false, a meteorologist is a scientist?
True.
Correct. What kind of radar system did Mish say storms were popping up everywhere on?
Doppler.
Yes. Rain shows up as what color on radar?
Green.
Correct. Where did the little girl think it was best to hide during a hurricane?
Raise the basement.
Correct. What hurricane were Mish and Taylor talking about?
Emily.
Correct. How did Mish become interested in weather?
A tornado hit her town as a little girl.
Yes. What color paint was used to outline the drawing on the mural?
Yellow.
Correct. How many squares did each of the boys have to paint?
Two? Five?
What's your final answer? Is it two or five?
Two.
Two it is. Correct. And that brings us to the end of our halftime quiz show. You answered 9 questions out of 10 correctly, which gives you a total of 45 points. Nice job. Now, the question you missed was the first one, but you recovered nicely. But question one was, let's say we had a hurricane named Jill. What would be a potential name for the next hurricane? Any boy's name that started with K.
Told you.
Alphabetical order, ladies. All right, that brings us to the end of our halftime trivia quiz. And with that, a fine 45-point gain for both of you.
Yeah.
So you may celebrate as we head back to our challenges.
All right, so Ruff and I have been chatting about your next assignment. We are going to take you to a wind tunnel.
That's right. Part two of this challenge, report in extreme weather conditions.
Ruff, I'm feeling a little nervous right now.
We're starting. I guess that's a yes.
What's the sound of? What is that? Oh, Taylor. You look like you're doing a video. Taylor?
This is Taylor reporting live at the scene of a Category 1 hurricane.
That's only a Category 1?
It's like hurricane tip. So be careful. Once again, this is Taylor. I'll be keeping you updated on this hurricane. Category 1 hurricane. Back to you guys in the studio. Hi, Rob. This is so cool. I don't even need a blow dryer anymore.
You don't? Your hair looks great. Good volume. And here comes the Mayor-mobile. Wow, that is a nice looking ride. Hey, Mayor. How's it going?
I just pulled up.
How's the mural looking?
Mural, it just looks great.
Listen, I'm having a problem with the cat next door.
I'll get back to you.
Okay, I guess we're done. Nice talking to you, sir. Boy, these politicians are busy.
What are they doing?
Oh, he's gonna meet my kids.
How are you?
Yeah.
What are we doing here? It's Mega Pond, isn't it?
Yep.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, he likes it.
All right, I got some from Ruff.
Okay, you don't have to read it. You can just kind of hand it to him.
All right, you can read it.
Hi, guys.
You are the mayor.
We have to finish the mural in time for a neighborhood sidewalk party to celebrate the new mural. The party starts at 4 p.m. And you are the host, so you guys can get this done by 4 o'clock or else.
Oh, that's awesome.
Awesome, let's get going.
Bye, man.
Wash my hands.
Thank you.
Hurry now,
Ruff.
We're hosting a party? Jeez, what will you think of next?
Ready? Right back. Right back.
You guys work hard. You deserve a party. I take care of my people. Just like the mayor does. The pressure is on. This crew has to finish this mural by 4 o'clock. It is now 3:15 and counting.
We're going to start with, you are going to be live on television really soon, so I've got to give you the crash course.
That's right. The third part of the challenge. A live weather report on TV. In front of millions.
And we have a whole series of graphics that we'll switch to one after another.
Oh, wow, that's so cool.
There you are.
Hi, me.
Anywhere this green color appears, our weather graphic shows up.
Whoa, what happened to the bucket?
Point to Chicago.
You're not pointing to anything. Oh, wait, yes, you are.
Oh, there it is. Point to Los Angeles. Where is it?
Oh, it's way back here.
Oh.
Go on the other side there.
Where'd you go?
I'm right here.
There we go. Your parents are going to have my hide. Don't put a coat on. Oh, you're not really in the winter. Good. Oh, that's weird.
Ruff, she's going to steal my job.
It looks so much easier when it's in fast motion.
Brian, you actually could help these guys with filling the green down.
More than I was worried because I really was never a good painter. But now it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun, and I'm not that bad at it.
That's why I like this kid. He just goes in and does it.
Okay, let's go take one final look at the wall and see what we've done. Remember how it was when you came this morning?
But that's supposed to happen.
Wow!
So you did a great job.
It looks awesome.
Hey, thank you.
Let's party!
And Brian, you can go back to your teacher, and you go ahead and you paint your turtle gator. Are those cupcakes? I love cupcakes.
You guys did an awesome job.
Okay, now granted, I didn't do any of the painting, but I sent three helpers. Shouldn't that entitle me to a burrito?
Thanks for coming to this neighborhood celebration of our mural of Jamaica Pond. We all worked really hard, along with the mayor's crew.
Thanks, guys, for doing an excellent job.
Awesome! Totally awesome!
You guys did an awesome job today.
Thanks.
Thanks a lot. Thanks. We couldn't have done it without you. Did a good job, man. Let's go dance.
Oh! Oh! Now there's some moves I could use.
He's calling you, Noelle. He's calling you out.
Oh! And she's getting down, too. Oh, Brian! Goodbye, mural painters of the mayor. All right, we are back here in Studio G with Anna and Julia, who racked up 45 points at the halftime quiz show. I think it's time we bring in our challenges. Well, here come Noah Rembrandt, Brian Picasso, and Khalil Monet, the Mural Brothers. Hey, nice hats.
Thanks.
So, how was your challenge?
Awesome.
Yeah. You learned.
It was hot, though.
It was a little hot.
Really hot.
Well, I think you guys would have benefited from a weather report. Why don't we watch one right now?
Good evening. Thanks for tuning in to CBS 4 News. It's been a busy weather day, and with the latest on our forecast, we go right to the Weather Center.
Taylor!
Hi, I'm Taylor from Fetch with Ruff Ruffman, taking a place in Michigan.
Plug for the show. Free plug.
Look at the temperatures around the country.
Okay, Taylor, point to the right
states. Right now, we're looking at Boston, 84.
Oh,
there's
nice
Montreal, 88. Philadelphia is 89 degrees.
She's pointing so well.
There. That was 79 degrees in Nashville.
And where?
I mean, 79 degrees in Atlanta.
Close enough.
99 degrees in Denver and 110 degrees in Phoenix. Oh,
okay, everybody's panting in Phoenix, apparently.
As you can see, this is the low-pressure area where the bad storm is and the high-pressure area where it's pretty hot. Let's take a closer look at Hurricane Emily. The eye of the storm is still on the water, so it should die down when it gets to land. Let's check out Taylor's forecast. Let's see. Tuesday, it's going to be 90 degrees, high 90 degrees,
too hot,
and a low of 74. Wednesday should be a high of 91 and a low of 70.
Even hotter, a day of smoothies.
And Saturday, it's cooling down, nice and easy.
Okay,
with a high of 83
nice.
And a low of
62. Maybe I'll go out for a little kibble.
Ruff.
I'm all set. Taylor, great job.
Taylor, that was awesome. What a great forecast. High five on that. I see you taking my job in a few years.
Let's bring her in.
Awesome job.
Thanks.
So, Taylor, how was your challenge?
Oh, my gosh. It was so awesome being a weather person, and especially that wind tunnel. That was crazy cool.
Oh, that was awesome.
How does the wind tunnel look so awesome?
How long did it take to comb that hair out?
About an hour, and it's still a little frazzled.
Point time. What do you say, guys?
Yeah, let's go.
All right, Taylor, for getting up there in front of that green screen and making it look like you've been doing it for years, for your professionalism, I give you 50 points.
Yes, good job. Ready to.
For braving the wind tunnel, 20 points.
Yes, job.
Now then, Taylor, some things you didn't know. Were you afraid to ask?
No. What exactly is the atmosphere?
And for asking good questions, 15 points.
Thanks,
Ryan. Awesome points, man.
So that brings our point total for you, Taylor, to 85 points.
Nice.
Oh, that's awesome. A good score. Now, on to our artistes.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, you made art today.
We did.
You did a mural. You get 50 points for that.
Good job, guys.
It was a blank wall before you started, and now it is not. For awesome teamwork and for not tracking paint into the studio, which I appreciate, 20 points.
Oh, 20 points.
It was a little hot out. For braving the elements, 5 more points for you guys. And 5 more points for the awesome dancing.
Good job, guys.
That brings your total to 80 points. Except for Brian. Now, Brian, you weren't too sure about this whole painting idea, were you?
I always thought painting was never my thing.
So you have discovered your inner artist there, Brian.
I guess I'm a little bit better now.
And for learning something new about yourself, that's another 5 points. That brings your total to 85 points.
Same as me.
But ladies and gentlemen, is that all the points a dog can give?
No.
What time is it?
Bonus time.
Bonus point time. Yes. Now, as you know, I'm connected with the animal kingdom.
And anytime I see an animal in this show, I smile.
Except for cats.
Except for cats. Now, for adding animals in the interview process, Taylor, I am going to give you another 10 points.
Yes.
Which means today's daily prize goes to Taylor.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Now, Taylor, as you know, your prize is in the mailbox. But is it a prize that is unforgettable or a prize you'd rather forget? It's your decision. You can keep it for yourself, and it could be great. Or it may not be so great, and you might want to give it to one of the other contestants. What do you want to do, Taylor?
I don't know. I was going to give it to my teammate, but I didn't have a teammate.
Take it for yourself.
Mish isn't here, so yeah. I think I'm going to take it for myself.
Take it for yourself, then step right up to the mailbox. Claim your prize.
The holder of this certificate is required to paint a large portrait of that fabulous TV host, Ruff.
It would be an honor to have a portrait of myself done by you, Taylor. And that's it, gang. Another fantastic episode of Fetch with Ruff. Ruffman is complete.
See ya.
So all until right, next time, take care, guys. And to all you cats out in the viewing audience, be advised, I am not amused. This is what's known in modern art as action painting. Ah! So, that little cat episode has cured me of my brontophobia. And hey, did you know Brontosaurus means thunder lizard? Yes, it got its name from the... It's not really thunder, it's just that cat again. Or is it? Okay, one last thing. Not only do I host my own television show, but I have a fantastic website, too. Check it out. There are tons of great games, the inside scoop on our contestants, and lots more. PBSKidsGo.org. Skip, scoodily bop. Skip, skip, skippy dooby dop. Chop, dooby dop. Bap, bap, beep, bap, beep, dop, dop.
Whatever.
Funding for Fetch with Ruff Ruffman has been provided by the National Science Foundation, where discoveries begin. The Arthur Vining Davis Foundations, dedicated to strengthening America's future through education. And by Arby's. And by Green Dog. And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.